Apple's yearly iPhone refresh wasn't quite the highly feature-rich one that everyone expected. But even then, it's managed to hold fort as one of the most popular and most desirable phones in the world.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my iPhone gave to me 12 cookies cooking.
The third avatar of the Apple's iPhone, arguably the world's most popular phone, was launched this year. But in the world of phones where you can no longer count camera megapixels on your fingertips, and with screen resolutions getting higher every day, the new iPhone 3GS was put into the market with such little upgrades, they can hardly be called that.
Now, since upgrades usually include a camera, most of us expected at least a 5-megapixel camera and an LED flash for taking pictures in the dark. That did not happen, nor did it come with the speedy Wi-Fi N.
The iPhone has always received criticism for its inability to take pictures in the dark. And well, the iPhone 3GS continues with that liability. There isn't even a secondary camera for actual 3G video calling, but the 3.2-megapixel touch-based autofocus camera did come with excellent quality video recording. Also, while the entire range of iMacs and MacBooks come with a speedy new Wi-Fi N technology, the 3GS was fitted with just basic Wi-Fi.
Actually, for internet browsing and app downloads, basic Wi-Fi is not a problem because stuff like music, video and photo syncing all happens over USB, but the screen resolution was still a little bit low.
A higher-res OLED screen that would consume far less power than an LCD screen was yet another desired feature, putting to rest all the previous jokes on battery life. Yet, the iPhone 3GS has the same old screen from previous versions.
Multitasking. Now, this one's important. Almost every smartphone out there lets you run multiple apps at a time and switch between them. The iPhone still does not.
The iPhone has all kinds of apps. There are apps to pick the perfect gift.
Windows Mobile, Series 60, Android. Even non-smartphones now offer switching abilities in their interfaces. But the iPhone still lets you run only one app at a time. But this could be a design decision. Multiple apps can lead to sluggish performance since the memory is limited. So with just one app at a time, the iPhone stays snappy all the time.
And an app that can light up the tree.
In spite of being such a mediocre hardware upgrade, the iPhone is still the most popular phone in the world. In fact, iPhone usage has overtaken Windows mobile phones in the US, and that definitely means something. You see, the iPhone is not really about the hardware and the specifications. It's the software and the way it integrates with the hardware and services that makes the iPhone such a desirable piece of technology. The iPhone 3GS is clearly a pick. Games based on wars took a completely new turn with the launch of the original Call of Duty Modern Warfare. It was a fast forward from the typical World War setting to modern-day battles with more relevant locations, bigger and better weapons and technology.